Hey, thank you. And here we go. Our time is 5:30.
Right now at 5:30, police arrested two men after shots were fired in a Lexington neighborhood. Who those men are just ahead on WKYT this morning.
Also ahead, after the Orlando shooting, the Lexington police chief is planning to meet with owners of gay establishments downtown. More on that meeting coming up this morning.
A man arrested after a 10-hour standoff with Lexington police will face a judge today. We'll have more on that story ahead on WKYT this morning.
This is WKYT This Morning.
Good morning on your Friday. We're so glad you're on WKYT to start off your day and lead to the weekend. I'm Bill Bryant.
I'm Rebecca Smith. It may be a big weekend for you, celebrating Father's Day. A lot of glad dads out there with the weather.
Yes, and a lot going on. A nice feel to the weather,
yeah,
as well as the temperatures and humidity being in check. So let's check in with meteorologist Micah Harris.
Yeah, and we're looking pretty good this weekend. I really don't see any problems. But today, we're still not out of the woods just yet, because we still are looking for that small chance of rain in the forecast, especially later on this afternoon. Temperatures are in the 60s and even a couple of 70-degree readings. So this morning, you won't feel that difference. The milder air actually comes later on in the forecast, later on this afternoon. 82, that's much, much nicer than what we felt yesterday and the day before. But most of those rain chances, guys, actually toward eastern Kentucky. I've built a graphic. I'm going to show you where I expect the best chance of rain and how far west it actually comes in just a few minutes.
And leading our news this morning, two teenagers accused of shooting at a pedestrian in a Lexington neighborhood have now been identified.
Yeah, we're told the two men were driving on Judy Lane near Paris Pike when shots were fired. WKYT's Mike Byer is joining us live with more details. Mike.
Good morning, Rebecca. Lexington police have arrested two teenagers who they say led them on a chase after shots were fired in a Lexington neighborhood. Police tell us, police say 19-year-old Xavier Johnson and 18-year-old Trevontis Lillard are responsible. Police tell us Lillard fired shots at a man on a sidewalk along Judy Lane near Paris Pike. An off-duty police officer who lives nearby heard what happened, saw the suspects, and began chasing them. Other officers quickly joined in. Police say they stopped the suspects and arrested them 2 miles away on Augusta Drive. Police charged Johnson, the driver, with fleeing and evading. They say the passenger in the car, Lillard, is charged with wanton endangerment. An officer who saw the suspects takes us through the scene. Now, the other good news besides the two men being arrested is no one was hurt in all this. So that is the good news this morning. Live in Lexington, Mike Byer, WKYT.
Well, today a man arrested after a standoff with police in Lexington will be in court. We first told you about the standoff on Deauville Drive yesterday morning. Ryan Stanley Kamark barricaded himself inside a home with his wife and two children. After 10 hours, Kamark surrendered peacefully. The wife and children were not hurt. Kamark is now charged with 4 counts of wanton endangerment. And the man accused of robbing a Red Roof Inn will also face a Fayette County judge today. Aaron Breingar is charged with robbery of the hotel on Wilhite Drive. That happened in February. According to our news partners at the Herald Leader, Breingar turned himself in on Wednesday. Bluegrass Crime Stoppers had offered a $1,000 reward for information on the crime.
Nearly 40 years after police say he escaped from prison, a Georgia fugitive has been arrested in southern Kentucky. Police say Billy Birchfield was serving a 16-year sentence for manslaughter when he escaped from a Georgia prison back in 1979. They say since then he assumed the name of a dead cousin and started calling himself Bill Arnold. A tip Wednesday night led them to a home in Laurel County where they confirmed the man living there was Birchfield. Neighbors say he used to own a gas station and a restaurant and was always willing to help anyone who needed it.
Just a great guy, a really good mentor, completely all the way around, just a great guy, really. I mean, he just blows my mind.
Laurel County deputies say Birchfield will be sent back to Georgia as soon as possible. His family members told us they had no comment on the arrest or his past charges. A man wanted for a bank robbery in Bowling Green has been found dead in Tennessee. Police say 58-year-old Eddie Connor robbed Citizen First Bank on Tuesday. They say Connor later broke into a home near Nashville to try to hide. And police say when the homeowner returned, he and Connor fired shots at each other, killing both men. They say Connor had an extensive criminal history and was even once the subject of an America's Most Wanted episode.
What started as a traffic stop led to a whole lot more for police in Madison County. Sheriff's deputies say 34-year-old Jerry Massengale and 48-year-old Ricky Sloan were inside a car they pulled over on East Main Street in Richmond Wednesday night. In that car, deputies found 65 grams of crystal meth, 19 grams of heroin, and $5,700 in cash. Both men face drug charges. A large fire ripped through a Kentucky McDonald's, causing quite a bit of damage. This happened yesterday about 4 in the afternoon at the McDonald's in Elizabethtown. Firefighters think the fire started in some mulch outside, then quickly spread to the building. At first, McDonald's workers tried to put out the fire themselves, but they couldn't. Firefighters say all customers and workers got out safely. One first responder did have to go to the hospital for heat exhaustion, but firefighters say he'll be okay. At this point, they say they do not suspect the fire was set on purpose.
Today, local gay businesses and Lexington police are expected to be meeting to talk about security issues. Michelle Chamberlain is at our live desk with the details of that. Good morning, Michelle.
Good morning, Bill. We know that Lexington's police chief will meet with the owners of all the city's gay bars today. Now, the focus of the meeting will be safety for their employees and customers. The security meeting comes after the mass shooting at a popular gay nightclub in Orlando that killed 49 people. The talks also come before Lexington's Pride Festival, which is set for June 25th. Business owners here are looking forward to moving forward. We know that meeting today is scheduled for 11 o'clock this morning in downtown Lexington. At the live desk, Michelle Chamberlain, WKYT.
Michelle, thank you. New cell phone video is proving, giving investigators a better glimpse of the terrifying moments inside the Orlando nightclub. We want to warn you, the following video may be disturbing to you and you might want to turn away. But here it is. The grainy cell phone video shows more than a dozen people packed into a bathroom stall as Omar Mateen fires shots inside the Pulse nightclub. And sources are telling CBS News that Omar Mateen checked social media for trending topics like Pulse, Orlando, and shooting right in the middle of the killing spree. Investigators say he also exchanged an I love you text with his wife, Noor Salman. Salman has been cooperating with police, but officials suspect she knew about the plot and likely will face some charges. 2 days after meeting with Hillary Clinton in Washington, Bernie Sanders announced that he will work with Clinton to transform the Democratic Party and prevent a Donald Trump presidency. Sanders spoke last night in a live stream address from his home in Vermont. He says he looks forward to additional talks with Clinton. He did not say that he was dropping out of the race entirely. Three wildfires driven by dry and windy conditions are raging in the west this morning, torching thousands of acres and also threatening hundreds of homes there.
Yeah, scary situation for those folks. Hannah Daniels has the latest.
This blaze near Santa Barbara, California, exploded Thursday night. Driven by wind, the flames marched from the mountains right down to the 101 freeway. Firefighters raced in with helicopters to drop water on cars in an effort to keep them and the freeway from burning.
It's insane, you know, it's nothing like I've ever seen, you know, it's terrifying, really.
Very dangerous, very dangerous.
Hundreds of firefighters are battling the California blaze using half a dozen air tankers and helicopters. Fire officials say this could be the worst wildfire season ever in the state.
This has been a significant and challenging fire. It's burning in an area notorious for life and property loss, structure loss, and fuels that have not burned for over 70 years.
In Arizona, firefighters are making progress against the Cedar Creek fire. The blaze has torched close to 8,000 acres. While hundreds have been evacuated, thousands more are under pre-evacuation orders, leaving many families very nervous.
They called in and said, "Mom, it's really scary out here. It's smoky. What do we do?"
Another fire, this one in New Mexico, has burned more than 12,000 acres. With continued dry conditions and a record-setting heat wave on the way to the western U.S., there may not be much help from Mother Nature on the way. Hannah Daniels, CBS News.
Some devastation there. The governor of New Mexico's declared a state of emergency in two counties.
Rock singer Meatloaf has been taken to a hospital after collapsing on stage during a concert. It happened last night in Alberta. The 68-year-old had canceled two other concerts in recent days, citing ill health. His condition is not known this morning. Meatloaf, whose real name is Marvin Lee Adey, is best known for his 1977 album, Bad Out of Hell. Lots of big hits, Two Out of Three Ain't Bad, and many more over the years.
Dashboard song? What is the dashboard
song? Right. Paradise by the Dashboard Light. You're right. That was another one of those back in those days. All right, 540. Philadelphia has become the first major American city to have a soda tax. The Philadelphia City Council approved a 1.5 cent per ounce tax on all sugary and diet beverages. The city plans to make $90 million from the new tax in the first year. City leaders say that money will be used to pay for pre-kindergarten community schools and recreation centers. The soda industry is expected to sue and try to stop the tax.
Part of the Lee County Courthouse has been closed because of some structural damage. County leaders there say in some courthouse offices, the floors have become detached from walls. They're trying to figure out why. The Family Support Protection and Permanency Services offices has been closed and temporarily moved to the Owsley County Courthouse. A structural engineer plans to look at the damage next week.
Part of a Whitley County road was dug up to rescue a dog from a drain pipe. A family's dog went missing on Tuesday, and Wednesday they found the dog had been stuck in a drain pipe under a road in front of their house. Firefighters couldn't get the dog out of the pipe. So yesterday morning, the county road department was called in, and they arrived and dug up the old drain pipe and freed Lily.
They were able to get the pipe out and the ground out to where the street is. And I got down into the ditch and called her. I could see her about 8 feet in.
Well, Lily is doing okay now. Looks so sweet. The Whitley County Road Department put in a much wider drain pipe so that she wouldn't get stuck in it again, just in case Lily gets all curious about what's under the road.
Such a sweet little beagle dog. Love those.
Absolutely. I'm glad Lily's free.
Yeah.
All right, coming up on 542 this morning, let's check live drive traffic for you and see what's going on early on your Friday. And it's pretty quiet out there. We're getting lots of indications that things are clean and clear out there on the roads. There is a look at the region on the current traffic map.
You know, it's looking A-OK. Here's a look at the Lexington Fayette Urban County Government's live drive cam. This view of New Circle and Meadow Lane. Pretty quiet out there for you on your Friday, but things will assured pick up.
When there's almost no cars on New Circle Road, that says a lot, right? This time
it really does. You know, maybe you took the day off.
Yeah, it's quiet, but it's early. And we have a lot more news coming up for you Friday on WKYT.
An eighth grader gave a widely popular graduation speech at his middle school in suburban Chicago. Find out why he had so many people laughing. Ahead on WKYT this morning.
Holding on to temperatures in the mid-60s early this morning. You're not going to feel that nice weather early this morning. It's actually this afternoon and then off towards your weekend. I'm going to talk about that and show you a small rain chance in there, too, coming up next.
Now, your hour-by-hour forecast with meteorologist Micah Harris.
Defender Radar Network showing a pretty clear start to the day. There's really not much going on. However, you got to look north of you because north, that's where we're going to be seeing those winds coming in from the north and northwest. Not only that, we're also going to be getting a little bit of moisture creeping on in. And that's going to be the case as we head towards your afternoon, really. There's still the rain back toward east of us, but for the most part, we're dry this morning. This afternoon, there is that small chance of rain. I'll show you where I expect that in just a few minutes. But current temperatures, we're sitting there in the 60s. It's not a great feel outside right now. Right now, coming out of Bluegrass Airport, it's 65 degrees. But once we go through the day, hour by hour, here's your step-by-step forecast to help you plan out your day. 7 a.m., 63 degrees. We're there in the mid-70s there by noontime. Notice we're not even getting close to the 90s today. We're actually dropping that temperature by 5 p.m., around 10 to about 13 degrees from where we were yesterday across the area. Now, you do see the rain chance icons on there, but remember, this is a small chance of rain. Not only that, but for the most part, it's that I-75 corridor and back toward the east. That's your best bet. And even eastern zones, you're still talking 40%. So it's not a great chance anywhere you go, but farther east you are, better likelihood. Watch this hour by hour forecast, and I'll show you what I'm talking about. And we get into your afternoon. Hey, don't forget, we still have a few events sparking up for today. And Cowbell Days, that's there in Stanford and Lincoln County. Nothing going on, right? There's noontime. Looks pretty good. Off into the evening, I don't see any problems. Watch over toward the east, though. Here we go with a couple of showers moving on in. Now, once we hit the afternoon, they're in Lincoln County. They're in Danville and Boyle County. What about Casey County, Springfield? There is a slight, I'm talking 10% chance that you actually see a passing shower. That is absolutely nothing to cancel plans over. I promise you that. Eastern zones, I still wouldn't cancel plans over there either because these are passing light showers. This is not a great chance to actually get a lot of rain out of this. So you'll get a passing light shower and then you're done. So stick to your plans, off towards your weekend. Your weekend does look much better. We'll get rid of this rain chance. There's 8 p.m., still holding on to that chance, really back toward the east. Let's talk about your weekend forecast real quick and show you that in your 7-day. Your 7-day, for the most part, doesn't look all that bad. The next couple of days into your weekend, 84 there on Saturday, 87. On Sunday, you'll have nice conditions, mid-80s, a little bit deceiving. The humidity will be down, so it'll actually feel quite nice. Mowing the grass, you can knock it out today, tomorrow, Sunday. Some of us don't need to do it. Some of us have been very dry, but some of us picked up tremendous amounts of rain the past couple of days.
Thought you just meant you were going to walk through the weeds.
Yeah, no kidding.
Let it
or
be.
Do that, right.
All right, looks good for just about anything outdoors.
I was like, I hope somebody's listening to that mow the lawn memo.
Yeah, a little hint, hint, huh? Okay, got you. Right, 5:48 is our time this morning, and lots of professionals are getting laughs impersonating this year's presidential candidacy. Let's face it, they're pretty easy to do, you know?
Well, you just showed me this video on your phone. It is hilarious, and the Illinois 8th grader got to share in the hype when he just nailed the voice of several candidates during his graduation speech. It began with the voice and gestures, of course, of Donald Trump. I personally thought he was going to save the best for last, but he led with it. Then he moved on to other candidates like Hillary Clinton and Bernie Sanders.
We will win, and we will win, and believe me, we will win. They've given us the skills we need to get through 6th grade and through 7th grade and through 8th grade. Let me start with the lunches. They are delicious. And some of the best cinnamon rolls I've ever tasted. We need to make them free. What we need is a cinnamon roll revolution.
Oh, wow. He is good. He is good, man. Jack Aiello's dad says his son wants to either be president one day or a comedian.
Well why not both, right?
Yeah, yeah. You could argue that what's the difference, right?
Sometimes these days you wonder,
you
right?
You do wonder. Yeah.
All right. Coming up on 6:50, 10 till 6 on WKYT this morning.
Yeah, we're so glad you're here with us. We've got more news at this hour.
Good morning. Welcome back into WKYT this morning. 5:53 is the time. We're rolling towards 6 o'clock on Friday.
Yeah, and let's take a look right now at some of the stories we're working on for you on this Friday.
Two men have been arrested after shots were fired at a man on a sidewalk in a Lexington neighborhood. It happened late last night along Judy Lane near Paris Pike. Trevantes Lillard is now charged with wanton endangerment and Xavier Johnson with fleeing and evading police. Police say no one was injured in that.
Kentucky Governor Matt Bevin expected to make what he is calling an important announcement today. We do not know what that announcement will be about. The last time the governor made an announcement, he said his administration had uncovered possible illegal activity by the previous administration.
And today, Lexington's police chief will be meeting with the owners of all of the city's gay bars. The focus of the meeting will be on safety for their employees and customers. The increased security comes after the mass shooting at a popular gay nightclub in Orlando that killed 49 people.
More details are emerging about the Orlando nightclub shooter Omar Mateen, and it tops your national headlines.
A Florida gun shop owner says Omar Mateen, the gunman who killed 49 people inside the Pulse nightclub, tried to buy body armor from a store, but employees turned him away and called the FBI. Yesterday, President Obama and Vice President Biden met with survivors and paid their respects to the victims' families in Orlando. The Cleveland Cavaliers beat the Golden State Warriors to force a Game 7 in the NBA Finals. Steph Curry fouled out late in the game, was ejected with under 5 minutes left in the contest, while LeBron James scored 41 points to help the Cavs defeat the Warriors 115-101. The series heads back to Oakland on Sunday. Pretty unlikely after the way it all started off, but the Cavs have come on.
All right. Good to know. Now for today's top health story, Swedish researchers have found that boys who are overweight as teenagers are more likely to develop heart failure in early middle age.
Yeah, the study discovered a sharp increase in risk for teens with a body mass index starting at 20, which is still in the range considered to be normal. They say it shows the importance of maintaining a healthy body weight from a very early age. The CDC is reporting more men are visiting family planning clinics, doubling their numbers in the last 11 years. Federal health officials say the trend is encouraging, but that women still make up 90% of the clientele. The clinics offer contraceptives, pregnancy testing, cancer, and STD screenings, as well as some other services.
Let's get a check right now on today's traffic travel spots on your Friday.
See what's going on out there. And first of all, here we have a look at some of the drive times heading into Lexington from some of the surrounding cities. All of those looking good. It's about a normal commute from, say, Paris, Georgetown, Winchester, Lexington, Frankfort. Should be a good ride in.
Yeah, it's looking A-OK. And here's another view of a traffic cam, the Lexington Fayette Urban County Government's live drive cam. New Circle and Meadow Lane looks good.
Yeah, some early birds finally getting out there this morning and getting on the circle.
And speaking of getting out there this weekend, you'll probably want to do that.
Oh, it's going to be really, really nice. Just right, Micah, with the temperatures down and the humidity lower.
That's the key right there, humidity being down. That's exactly what you want during this time of year heading off into summer. We're not at summer just yet. That actually comes in the next few days. But we're sitting there in the 60s. Now, this morning, you won't feel that difference that we've been talking about. Later on this afternoon, absolutely. We'll actually be in the lower 80s later on today. And not only that, but the humidity continues to slowly but surely drop. The weekend looks great, but we just got to get through a couple of more showers today. It's mainly for the eastern zone, so we're going to be talking about that on WKYT News at 6 coming up in just a couple of minutes. And your weekend forecast, we'll see you right back here in about 2 minutes.